Gabriel commanded, read. The prophet said, ma ana bikari. I am not learned. Exactly verbatim what has been prophesied in the Old Testament in the book of Isaiah chapter 29 verse number 12. It further mentioned in the Song of Solomon chapter number 5 verse number 16. It says, Hikko mamitakim vikulli muhammadim zahdudi wa zairai baina Jerusalem. It's a Hebrew quotation which says that his mouth is more sweet, is altogether lovely. If you analyze Hikko mamitakim vikulli muhammadim in Hebrew language, in the Semitic languages, im is a word for respect, plural of respect, im, like Elohim. It's for respect, a plural of respect. Similarly, the word is Muhammad, added with im, peace be upon him, Muhammadim. So actually, even his name is mentioned in the original manuscript. But in translation, they've translated, his mouth is more sweet, he's altogether lovely. Muhammadim, they've translated as altogether lovely. He's my beloved, he's my friend, O daughter of Jerusalem. So by name, even the name of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is there in the original manuscripts of the Bible. Then there may be some Christians who will say that, see, we don't believe in the Old Testament. You know, we give more importance to the New Testament. Alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even the New Testament prophesizes the advent of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If you read, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 16. Jesus, peace be upon him, says that I shall ask my Father to send you another Comforter. Further, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 15, verse number 34. When my Father sends the Comforter, he shall glorify me. It further mentions the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 7. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter shall not come. For if I depart, shall I send him. Now the word used for Comforter in the present Bible that you find is Parakletos. It is actually a corrupted form of Perikletos. Perikletos actually means one who praises, one who is praiseworthy. Praiseworthy in Arabic is Muhammad. And one who praises in Arabic is Ahmad. Alhamdulillah, both of which were names of the last and final messenger Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. As the Quran says in Surah Saf, chapter 61, verse number 6, that Jesus, peace be upon him, the son of Mary, was sent as a messenger to Bani Israel. And he said, I have come to confirm the law that came before me, and giving glad tidings of a messenger to come after me, whose name shall be Ahmad. Peace be upon him. So the Quran says that he will prophesy by name in the law and the gospel. So the original word is Parakletos, which means a praiseworthy or one who praises. The corrupted form is Parakletos, which is translated as Comforter. Even the actual meaning of Parakletos is not Comforter, it is one who's kind. But irrespective whether it is Parakletos or Parakletos, whether it's praiseworthy or one who praises, or kind, or comforter, alhamdulillah, all these meanings, they apply very well to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. There may be some Christians who may say that, see, this prophecy actually is indicating to the Holy Spirit. It's not referring to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. But if we analyze the prophecy, it says that it is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the comforter shall not come. For if I depart, shall I send him. The criteria for the comforter to come is that Jesus, peace be upon him, should depart. And we know that the Holy Spirit was there before Jesus, peace be upon him. He was even there when Elizabeth gave birth. He was there when Jesus, peace be upon him, was being baptized. So surely, this comforter which the Bible speaks about doesn't refer to Holy Spirit, because Holy Spirit was already there when Jesus, peace be upon him, was present. And further mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14, that I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that the earth shall speak. And he shall testify me. He shall glorify me. He shall show you things to come. Again, this spirit of truth which the Bible speaks about is about the prophecy of the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So if you read the Bible, even the Bible prophesizes the advent of the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. There were several revelations sent on the face of the earth. By name, we know four, which are mentioned in the glorious Quran. The Torah, the Zabur, the Injil, and the Quran. The Torah is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to Moses, peace be upon him. The Zabur is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to David, peace be upon him. Injil is the Wahi, the revelation which was given to Jesus, peace be upon him. And Quran is the last and final revelation which was given to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Otherwise, there were several revelations that came on the face of the earth. By name, only four are mentioned in the Quran. But all the revelations that came before the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, they were meant only for a particular group of people. And their complete message was meant only for a particular time period. But the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, was not revealed only for the Muslims or for the Arabs. The Quran says in Surah Ibrahim, chapter number 14, verse number 52, it says that here is a message for the humankind. Let them take warning therefrom. Let them know there is only one God. Let the men of understanding take heed. So the last and final revelation, Quran, was revealed for the whole of humankind. The message repeated in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 185, that Ramadan was the month in which the Quran was revealed as a guidance to the whole of humankind and a criteria to judge right from wrong. The Quran says in Surah Az-Zumur, chapter 39, verse number 41, that we have revealed to thee, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the book to instruct humankind. It doesn't say to instruct only the Muslims or the Arabs, but to instruct the whole of humankind. So the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, was revealed for the whole of humanity. Therefore, all the revelations that came before the Quran, since they were only meant for a particular time period, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not think it fit to maintain in its original pure form. The only religious scripture that we have today, which has maintained its original form, is the glorious Quran. As William Moore, who is one of the strongest critics of Islam, he said, there is no religious scripture which has maintained its pure form, as pure as the glorious Quran, for 12 centuries. This he mentioned 200 years before. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, word number 1, hadith number 7, he said, that Islam is based on 5 pillars. First is, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, that there is no God but Allah and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the messenger of Allah. Second is Salah. Third is Zakat. Fourth is Hajj and fifth is Saum. The first is that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, as the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the concept of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Quran says in Surah Baqarah chapter number 2, verse number 177, it's not righteousness that you turn your face to the east or west, but it is righteousness that you believe in Allah. You believe in the hereafter, life after death. You believe in His books. You believe in the angels, and you believe in His messenger, as well as the destiny. The glorious Quran says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, it says, Kul ya ahl al-kitab, say, O people of the book, say, O Jews and Christians, ta'ala ila kalmatin sawa'in bainana bainakum, that come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah na'budu illallah, that we worship none but Allah, wala nushrika bihi shay'an, that we associate no partners with Him, ولا يتخذ بعضنا بعضا أربابا من دون الله.